Good morning, everyone. Beautiful weather in Vienna. It's 8th of October. Fatih just arrived, actually. We just loaded the car and we are on our way to Czech Republic for Operation Kandahar III. Our first break is shopping, so we need to get all the food now for the next 2 days and missions and so on. We came to Hofa, Aldi, and we're gonna get some food. Still have 4 hours of drive left, so we are at the still beginning of the tour. How is it going, Fatih? Very good. All right. So most probably we will see each other one more time in camp maintenance. We are in Kronen. It's a very long queue. We are right in the middle. This is gonna take a while. At least we parked the car, we found our tent and we found our platoon, and we are going to meet them after Kronen. And let's see, the briefing will start at 7 o'clock in the evening and the game will start at 8 o'clock. Until we got ready, actually it's already dark. We have already camped, we already loaded out our gear and stuff. Let me just try to show you maybe a little bit of the camp. Everybody is trying to get ready. Here are the tents, this is the base. As you can see, there are the toilets there, all the tents around here for the all squads and platoons. All geared up. Tomorrow, if I will have the chance with the sunlight, I will be able to show you even more. But for tonight, I think in the dark, it's getting really dark, so we are going to start around 8:30. All right, guys, we got our mission. This is the map. So it's around 10 o'clock. So most probably we are going to start in 10 minutes walking. We are currently here in the Airsoft base and we have to go through the let's say the border, and we need to basically cross this 17th village, and we need to meet up with the Charlie 10, and we have to basically grab some Taliban leaders most probably.
And most wanted.
Yes, so basically this is going to be the mission. The walking there will be most probably around 2 hours. We'll see.
And can you close the door, please?
As far as we understand, the mission will have to end at 3 o'clock in the morning. Let's see. It was a very interesting evening. We are really tired. This is the first milsim, as I told you. Now I'm going to Fatih. He's also almost dead. So what happened during the night that we couldn't record, because honestly it was completely dark. May I?
Yeah.
So it was completely dark, and it was a very long walk. Until the mission, we basically walked around 4.5 kilometers in no light. We were also not allowed to use our headlights and stuff, so that we didn't give our position, so that we don't give our position to the enemy. And it was not a straight walk. We walked through jungles and hills and stuff. We climbed in complete darkness. Incredible walk, really. And S2 snipers in between, we had some spare missions to go up on the hill and check if the enemy has positioned somewhere, or if we can find the path to the mission point. We had three separate missions like that. Most probably we did well. In between, we were almost about to get lost, actually, because we don't know the area, and it's completely
dark
and it's so big, and there is no voice, nothing, no lights. So I don't know, we fell, I have no idea how many times, and so on. And then at around 3 o'clock in the morning, we came to the point, which was up on a hill in a very steep position, and the whole platoon, basically we sat down and we had to hold that position until 3 o'clock in the morning. I have a 1 minute shot of a video in night vision where the Afghan forces, or the Taliban forces, or the Afghan rebels, we don't know even who, maybe it was our own people, maybe.
No, I don't think so,
because they shouted in whatever language, I have no idea.
Exactly.
But it was so dark that actually we even did not see what's happening. So all of a sudden we heard some shouts and everybody started shooting at blank to darkness, let's put it that way. We also got some shots. We were shot because we were sitting ducks on a open place, the whole platoon. The whole thing is that we had to hold that point until 3 o'clock, and we did. Basically, there were also many survivors from the platoon. We held the point until 3 o'clock, and then the mission was over. After that, the real pain started, because we had to come back.
Last dinner of Jesus.
Last supper.
Last
supper. So 4.5 kilometers long at 3:30, we had to walk back.
1 or 0 degrees Celsius.
We were in agony, honestly. It was a very interesting experience. I'm not sure how to call that experience, if it was a good experience, fun experience, painful experience, sad
experience,
exactly, maybe some other type of experience, but this is how it went. So right now it's around 10:30. It's actually a cold weather, there is a little bit wind, but at least we have the sun shining on us,
and we can see something.
And we are back to seeing like normal people again. Our whole team, so Charlie 20, is sleeping
in HQ.
In the HQ, so maybe not all, half of them are still sleeping. Charlie 10 went on another mission already in the morning, so we didn't join them. I have no idea if it was voluntarily or if, but it was not mandatory. We had our coffees, which were 40 cents. So we had two nice coffees. Now we will most probably have some breakfast. We will try to have some new briefing and see what today's mission is going to be, when it's going to be. In the meantime, maybe I can record the camp Nathan Smith a little bit for you. There are interesting cars and vehicles around here in the headquarters. And we will get back to you. Any other words?
Show must go.
See you guys.